Hey, thanks for saving my spot, big guy. Really appreciate it. It also helps with the lighting. Yeah, he doesn't say much. Hi, this is Andy Mangels, and welcome to day 121. It is Star Wars theme week this week, and that's in honor of the upcoming May the 4th, the official Star Wars holiday. Now, it's pop and rock music today, and this song was inspired by the Disney Plus series, The Book of Boba Fett. It was originally sung by NerdOut, a musician group of three who record songs about video games, movies, and pop culture. As you can imagine, I have a bit of a history with the big guy here, Boba Fett. My first professional Star Wars piece was an article about him that led to me regularly working for Lucasfilm from 1994 to 1998. In fact, in July 1998, in celebration of my success on Star Wars and my love for Boba Fett, I got my first tattoo. The red Mandalorian mythosaur skull, which is worn on my shoulder in exactly the same spot that Boba Fett wears it on his armor. Now, for three decades or so, nobody knew what it was because, frankly, nobody was cool enough to know Boba Fett like we know Boba Fett, right? Now, in 1996 to 1997, I also wrote a comic series called Boba Fett, Twin Engines of Destruction. And at one point in time, that book was voted as the best single Star Wars comic ever published. Now, the book established two important things about Boba Fett. Number one, that he never took off his helmet in front of others. And number two, the reason he didn't was because, as he said, this is my face. Let's flash forward 30 plus years later to The Mandalorian getting ready to debut on television. And the entire premise of the show is the Mandalorians never take off their helmet in front of others. And the reason why is because they say things like, this is the way. This is my face. This is the way. This is my face. This is the way. This is not taking off the... You know, I'm thinking that if the Mandalorian people were so inspired by my comic and the concepts therein that they would base an entire series on it, that they might at least, I don't know, name a character after me or give me a thank you in the credits or even send me a jacket or something. I guess. You know what? It was work for hire, and it's probably just a huge, huge Hollywood coincidence. We'll call it that, right? Now, I want to dedicate today's song to the Mandalorian Mercs, who made me a full member in 2011 in honor of my work on Star Wars in general and on Boba Fett in particular. But I especially want to dedicate this to four of those Mercs: Logan Shepard, Alex Cole, Robert Wentland, and Mala Fox, who were the Mandalorian honor guard at my wedding to my husband, Don, in 2017. This bounty is for you. Trading shots for a check, never choosing sides. No time for regrets, no. Yeah, you all heard my voice about 1,000 times. This might be your last, though. Oh, these Sams that I call my own, the life that I call my home, I've come back to take my throne. Send me down, give me up, left my destiny for dead. But right now, you're the one with a bounty on your head. I was born for greatness, father did the same shit. Take it to the underworld we go. Yeah, right now, you're the one with a bounty on your head. And I run the show. High above, but I walk on my own two feet. Give my allegiance to no one. A simple man made his way through the galaxy. I'm gonna live like I've chosen. Oh, these sands that I call my own, the life that I call my home. I've come back to take my throne. Sent me down, gave me up, left my destiny for dead. But right now, you're the one with a bounty on your head. I was born for greatness, father did the same shit. Take it to the underworld we go. Yeah, right now, you're the one with a bounty on your head. And I run the show. Take my place on the throne. Sent me down, gave me up, left my destiny for dead. But right now, you're the one with the bounty on your head. I was born for greatness, father did the same shit. Take it to the underworld we go. Yeah, right now, you're the one with the bounty on your head. And I run the show. Well, we sure showed them, huh? Yeah, still not saying anything, huh? Oh, well, I'll talk for us. All right, we hope you enjoyed that, Boba and I, and we hope you'll be back tomorrow to see what next we have in store for Star Wars Theme Week. In the meantime, I think we should go rescue those poor gay Gamorrean guards that you let kind of fall off a cliff or something. That was cold, dude. Really, really cold. We'll see you tomorrow.